Have you picked the wrong marketing objectives within Google Ads, or do you not even know where to start? Well, continue watching and we'll help you pick. Hi, I'm Lexie. I'm an e-commerce account manager here at AdPeople. This is actually my second video, so if you'd like to check out my first one on social proofing, then we'll add the link below. But today, we're going to talk about marketing objectives, conversion goals, and conversion actions. So the first page that you'll encounter after creating a Google Ads campaign will be your marketing objectives. So today, we're going to go through them. The first objective that you'll look at is sales. Now, this does what it says on the tin, essentially. So if you want to drive more online sales for your e-commerce business, then this is the one for you. So what if you're a business that doesn't focus on e-commerce sales online? Well, leads is definitely a marketing objective that you can look at. This will encourage users to take actions on your website, so be it calls, emails, or contact form submissions. What if you're a new business just starting out? Well, website traffic will help encourage the correct traffic onto your site. This is perfect for building a really good foundation of data to collect and store and work towards better campaigns for the future. The next marketing objective is product and brand consideration. Now, this will help increase traffic onto your website, but there's the added benefit of being able to see the data per individual product page. Now, this is particularly interesting for small to medium-sized businesses because you can see if you've had lots of views, maybe lots of clicks, but very few conversions. Perhaps it's time to look at that individual page and get that conversion rate up. We have done another handy video on conversion rate optimization with Tom, so feel free to check it out. Another simple objective is brand awareness. So if you're looking to broaden your reach or expand into new audiences, then this is the one for you. A bit of advice from my experience, using website traffic will help increase the correct traffic to your site better than brand awareness. So bear that in mind if you've got quite a small budget. The next one is app promotion. So if you have an app, obviously this is the marketing objective for you. This will help increase installations of your app and also increase engagement within the app itself. Since Shopify have released an app which you can create in Shopify, it can work alongside this campaign type very nicely. Another added benefit is the cost per acquisition, so your cost per sale, tends to be quite low on this type of campaign, which means you could see a really good return even if you have quite a small budget. So what if you have a physical store that you want to increase the foot traffic within? Well, local store visits is definitely the marketing objective for you. A benefit of this type of campaign is if somebody is searching for your goods or services nearby, then you will appear on Google Maps. Now, the final marketing objective is a custom one. Now, this is something that I would suggest staying away from as it tends to work without any goal guidance, meaning you're not working towards traffic increase, leads, or conversions. So definitely try and stay away. Now you've completed your marketing objectives, it's time to set conversion goals. So head over to Tools and Settings, Conversions, and click Conversion Goals. There are two types of conversion goals, primary and secondary. Now, primary means that Google will automatically be optimizing your account towards this goal, and you will be bidding actively towards this conversion goal. It will also be tracked in your conversion column. Secondary means it's more of a gathering data sort of approach. So they'll still be stored within your all conversions column, but you'll not be actively optimized for those goals. Now looking at conversion actions, there's loads to choose from, but the main three are purchases, traffic, and leads. So quickly, purchases, trying to increase those online sales for your e-commerce business. Traffic, increasing the relevant traffic onto your website. And leads, phone calls, emails, or contact form submissions. Now the final thing for you to do is to select the correct bidding strategy for your marketing objective. Now, we have done quite an in-depth video on this where Chris goes through each individual strategy. So that will be linked below, but you can also see it here. Go check it out. Now, we know it can be confusing, especially when you're starting new. So I hope you found this video useful. And if you run into any hiccups, then just let us know in the comments below and I'll get back to you. Thank you very much for watching though. Make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the notifications button so that you don't miss out on any more useful tips.